Hello everyone, my name is Dominono, welcome back to Bioshock 2. So, here we are. We need to get to Tannenbaum. And I couldn't pick that up because I'm full on rivets. I'm literally riveted. Oh, hello. Lamb will lead the way. Yeah, okay, I get it. Oh, hello again. Big sister. You're pretty cool, aren't you? In spite of your fishbowl face. Although I guess I'm not one to talk.
Quickly, head for the elevator.
Okay.
Hey there, enough for you. Gotta stop with your hands.
Successful. Yeah, I get it. Gun stand. This gun at the very least doesn't seem to have a lot of punch to it. Ow. I guess that's where I was supposed to learn to do first aid. Get drilled. Sick. How are you guys doing, like, any damage to me whatsoever? I'm massive. Need more first aid. That was a little rougher than I expected, but then the last game I played before this was Overwatch. Okay, then. I need to try and be more careful. Like, I'm still mostly used to Bioshock 1 with my ridiculously superpowered wrench, but I need to bear in mind that my stuff is less than perfectly leveled right now. Go away. Wow, that's a lot of you. Get him, security, go. Bunch of angry Muppets.
Now, here is what the children tell me.
Oh?
You are a very old Big Daddy. Bonded for life to a single little one.
Uh-huh.
When you are apart for too long, your body begins to shut down like a coma.
Right.
As long as the girl is in the rapture, you are trapped here as well. The name of your little one is Eleanor Lamb.
Right.
Daughter of Sophia.
Okay.
She is kept at Fontaine Futuristics on the other side of the city. You must go there and save her before it is too late.
Okay, then. Fontaine Futuristics. Even after we fucking murdered him in the last game, Fontaine's still proving to be a pain in the ass. Hello. Hey, buddy. You look a lot like Andrew Ryan, but you're probably not. Oh. I see. You were there to explain what those are. Trap rivets will never fire against you. Ah, that's convenient. Mouse key for changing the enemy types. Ah, that's pretty cool. Alright then. So, you know, it occurred to me, isn't Tannenbaum German for Christmas tree? Does that mean her name is Christmas tree? Probably not. That's probably like a perfectly legitimate reason. But, hey-ho. I like Christmas. Christmas is in a couple months.
Dr. Su Chong's death was a nasty blow to the protector program. But
and a victory for life.
To his role, picking up the slack that his carelessness left behind. We are gaining steam again, but I'm not satisfied. Yes, the Big Daddy defends the girl, but he is programmed only for the fight. Like a sheepdog who wanders off unless a wolf is tearing at his flock.
Yeah.
When no aggressor is present, he regards his little sister as he might a common houseplant. We need something more. Something stronger. An unbreakable physiological bond.
Uh-huh. So they thought that the Big Daddies were wandering away too much and decided to do something a little different. Uh-huh. Not sure I 100% understand just what you're getting at there, but something, clearly. So, trap rivets then. Can I? Yep, I can. Yeah. That's quite cool. Plus, me having it be middle mouse button is better than having it be B, since that's quite out of the way of my fingers.
Look at the baby. She won't even know it's there.
What are you doing?
I don't have her.
Weirdo. Sounds like... Oh, hello. Intercom. Tannenbaum, hello.
You see? This is why I must fight Sophia Lamb. She is using the new little ones for something. And I have returned to rescue them.
You're a good lady.
If I do not, more children will die for my sins. And the rapture nightmare will repeat forever. Now, we must talk.
Citizens of Rapture.
Oh, I'm good.
This is Subject Delta. Behind that mask hides an enemy of the people, without soul or sympathy.
What a manipulative
shit. It is a beast apart, and as family, we must tear out its jaw and drive it back into the sea.
Why my jaw? Is that like because I can't speak?
I will take this place apart to find you. Please hold back the splicers until we escape.
Okay. I got your back. I want that hacked out. I love that shit. Come here, you punk. Fuck off. I've got a big old rivet gun. Ow. Why do you do so much damage? That's malarkey. You just call me a scrub. Jerk. Hmm. It looks like it's trying to get me to rely on the plasmids more.
Now I must leave you, and I am sorry for this. But there are others I must help before the city drowns. This man Sinclair, he is an ally, and will guide you to Eleanor.
Okay.
Goodbye, Herr Delta. And good luck.
Goodbye, Christmas tree.
Well, look at you. A bona fide knight in armor, complete with iron horse.
What part of Tennessee are y'all from?
Esquire. Old Tannenbaum and I share an interest in the old Fontaine building, the very same place you'll find Eleanor Lamb.
I wish it would stop.
I think you and I can do business. Take the train to Ryan Amusements. I'll see you shortly.
Grand. Is there a way to turn off that things every time I hack the bloody things? Adaptive training? What does that even mean? Oh, helmet HUD graphic? I'm kind of getting used to that though at this point. Unusable item, vitagem, item shimmer. Let's see if it's that. First aid, hypos. Rivets. I'm getting more money earlier on than I expected to. Right, so that's the critical shit. Is there anything else useful around here? Schedule. Dionysus Park. Cancel, cancel, cancel. Ryan Amusements. Fontaine Court. Everywhere. Just Ryan and Fontaine. Fucking, like, 10 years after the fact, even. This pair of nerds couldn't just fucking leave each other alone. Right then. I'm not stuck. Did I even, like, make sure that... No, I forgot to apply it. Fine. Maybe this will do something useful. I hope so, because I'm sick of getting that as fucking, like... You pressed the blue! Good job! Like, I get it. I'm a big daddy. My brain power is limited, but I'm not completely stupid. I understand the idea of get in blue for be better than get in green. Me brain am work. The hack tool, yeah, I know that. Elstead, yeah, I know that too.
Whoa there! Now better apply the brakes unless you're aiming to dash yourself against that glacier up ahead.
I'm assuming this is the part where I need to go find the incinerator. Plasmid. Or a flamethrower, I guess. That could be nice too. Flamethrower's not really my kind of weapon, personally.
As you can see, Chief, the station here's iced over. To reach Eleanor Lamb at Fontaine headquarters, we'll have to clear the way.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in order to melt that ice, you'll need a plasmid like a handful of hellfire.
What do you know? I knew it.
We used to sell a fine old product called Incinerate, In the amusement park up yonder?
The amusement park.
Find a way in. I've already been on all the rides.
Why do you sell incinerate at the amusement park? Hello? What are you an advert for? Mussels. Oh, I love mussels. Do you like mussels? I love mussels. Mussels are great. Well, the sauce can affect mussels pretty heavy. I don't like buttercream. Buttercream is how mussels are usually done, and I don't like that. I like chili sauce. Mussels and chili sauce. Visit the museum. New at the gift shop. Eat at El Dorado. That's probably a Mexican place. Journey to the surface, hall of the future. Sick. This is going to be fun. I hope. If you don't like mussels, like, here's a pro tip. Don't look at them when you eat them, because mussels look gross. We are but the stone spit that we have. Okay, I get it. You're all essentially homeless by the looks of it, too. Like, I just find it strange that there's just all this stuff is just hanging around Rapture. Like, there's a big emphasis on, like, that the splicers seem to be sleeping rough. Like, they're not getting, like, any of their homes or shit. She is our savior. We will be reborn. Great. Hello.
Eleanor is progressing brilliantly. My physical participation in her birth was minimized, of course. It is vital that I am unhindered by nature's crude bias.
You're garbage.
I will be, above all, her intellectual progenitor. Loyal not to her, but to the people she will ultimately save. But I admit, it is with some measure of pride that I review her marks in standard intelligence tests. As an agent of our beliefs, she may surpass even me.
Boy, you were fucking crazy in your own way, aren't you? Recurring theme with living in the bottom of the ocean, apparently, is that everybody seems to have gone nuts. Like, your particular flavor of nuts is... That was not the right way to phrase that. Your particular flavor of insanity seems to be both overwhelming arrogance a la Ryan and Fontaine, but with
welcome
a holier-than-thou bent.
Insert your ticket now. Half price for children under three.
Half price for children under three? Children under three aren't going to give a shit about any of this. Like, for fuck's sake, they need to be at least 5 or 6 before they can appreciate an amusement park for its fucking hall of the future. I wonder how propagandist all that shit in there is.
You're a rare old model, son.
That a fact?
Alpha Series, I believe.
Oh.
Now, Rapture's full of scientific wonderments just like you. And if we can sell them to the world at my price, well, curing your condition ought to be a cakewalk. Once we find Eleanor, the sky's the limit.
Why is that? Oh, hello. One of the upgrade stations. I mean, I have, like, basically nothing to upgrade at the moment, so I'm assuming that this is just going to be for the fucking riven gun, but hey-ho. Drill damage... But it applies to both drill spin and melee attacks. I'm glad it said that. Hello. Drill reflector. Ah, so if you upgrade both things, you get a new one. That's cool. Rivet gun damage. Rivet gun clip size. Drill reflector. An electromagnetic dynamo is powered by the drill's rotation. Projectiles will be reflected while the drill is spinning. That's interesting. I dig melee damage, so yeah, let's stick weird giant side bits on it. Fair enough. Right then. More rivets. Desk for some shit. More jellyfish, I think. Yeah. Albeit not mobile ones. Weren't a lot of jellyfish in the first Bioshock. That water looks interesting. Important stuff. More shit, more audio logs.
I was hired to engineer a park the likes of which no man has seen.
Mm-hmm.
Now all I do is watch over it like a grizzled sheepdog. My first line of mechanical puppets made the children here cool with wonder. But Ryan thought my vision was immature. Antiquated, he said. This place could have been something magical. But instead, he turned it into a school. No, a cathedral. Dedicated to himself.
Wonderful. Seems to have been a recurring theme among people who built stuff for Rapture that everything just went for shit later. Hello. Oh. Is that Big Sister or is that Big Daddy? That's a daddy by the sound of him. Unless Big Sister's been hitting the testosterone. Ticket. Ooh. Sweet.
Jim Dandy. That'll get you in the park. But buying incinerate's gonna cost Adam. It's a sort of genetic goo that lets you rewrite whatever God gave you.
I am aware of
the
what Adam is.
The sisters carry the stuff, as you may recall, so you'll need to locate one. I heard a whisperer near the El Dorado Lounge. Have a look.
Fair enough. All right, so I guess this is going to be the tutorial for fighting Big Daddies again.
Get yourself clean. No fuck-ups this time.
Hello.
Daddy's home.
Fuck you.
Take aim.
Drop that at once. It's priceless. The shadows won't hide you for long.
The wolf. Bing, bang, boom. Yeah. Why am I so, like, fucking weak? Like, I'm a Big Daddy, for God's sake. I'm supposed to be wearing a giant armored diving suit, and yet every time somebody so much as grazes me with a bullet, my health just seems to disappear. Oh well. I guess it would be kind of overpowered if I was just a fucking humongous monster straight off the bat.
I am Andrew Ryan. Welcome to Ryan Amusements. Please, enjoy the park.
Thanks. Sports boost. Yes, gene tonics. Yeah, I get it. I have a lot of slots. Move slightly faster. Fair enough. Why not? Which way am I going, then? Gift shop. Presumably there. Oh, hello. Just a gap here. Alright. Not this way, then. 50 caliber rounds. That must be for something heavy duty. Ah, if I click on the thingy again, it changes my... ammo. That's useful.
Andrew Ryan wakes one night while cruising the Atlantic in his steamliner, the Olympian.
Uh-huh.
His sleep interrupted with a singular purpose. Here, he shouts to his crewmen as he wipes sleep from his eyes. Full stop. We begin building here.
Do we? Oh, good. What the hell's that?
The Olympian returns with a new cargo, a state-of-the-art submersible platform, nicknamed the Sinker, ferries supplies and workers to the seafloor, fathoms below.
Huh, that's pretty cool, actually. There's another one of those fucking great chain monuments, because boy was Ryan in love with those.
After initial supplies have been brought to the seafloor, the platform is permanently moored in the sediment. Massive iron girders are sunk hundreds of feet into the rock and silt. Below the platform, engineers work to overcome obstacles such as diamond hard rock, obstinate sea life, and unexpected challenge.
Uh-huh. Gee, I wonder if we're gonna get to the sinker at some point. I hope so. That might be cool to see. I hear the sound of tinkering, which is my guide to progress. Some dollars, a shoe, and some blood. Oh, hello. What the fuck? Ugh. Your feet are disgusting. Like, I... That's... No, that's the worst. Rapture grows. That's the gift shop. Fair enough, what does it say?
After the platform is secured, work progresses at an astounding rate. Designed to be the foundation of Rapture, workers toil around the clock to create the metropolis you see today.
Uh-huh. It's a bummer, really, when you think about like how big the place is, how much work and how much effort must have gone through it to wind up as a pile of trash full of druggies. Hall of the future. Right, I need to get to El Dorado because Sinclair, our best friend, said that's where we will find some sisters. Ain't it?
He won't listen. She's prettier now.
Out of my face, nerd. Yeah, the rivet gun doesn't feel super good. It's like very light. It's not chunky like the ones that the Rosies in the first game use. Anything interesting here in the gift shop? Restrooms. I know I just said I needed to get to the El Dorado restaurant, but you know, I want to have a look around first. Open sesame. Ah, wonderful. Always stuff in the bathrooms. First aid heavy rivets, huh? Presumably that's for big stuff.
I know the surface, Eleanor. I spent half a lifetime there, in service of the common good. But then, I heard my own words twisted by fat old men squatting over the embers of Hiroshima.
Ugh.
Were the modern world a patient in my care, I would diagnose it suicidal. On perhaps that point alone, Andrew Ryan is correct. Rapture is deliverance.
Alright then. So, you were somehow involved with the atomic bomb and ultimately became disillusioned with the world. Fair enough, that's a respectable thing to be disillusioned about. That was an atrocity of an unparalleled scale. Dolls. Bullshit. Who will be my mama? Ninny lions, doll babies. In your rapture directory under toys. Sinclair toys. Oh, so Sinclair was the toy maker. Fair enough.
Used to be there was no margin in running the gift shop. I couldn't hardly sell off this tourist crap for a penny more than the cost of manufacture. Then I met a straight shooter named Sinclair.
Mm-hmm.
And he laid a sweet deal on me. Says he's got some hard luck folks down at Popper's Drop could whip up this junk at half the cost I used to pay.
Fair enough.
I had to pick a needle or two out of the shipments, but all in all, nobody's the wiser. And I'm all the richer.
Uh-huh. What the fuck? Piece of shit. Fuck you. Bastard. So, you couldn't even be bothered to make your children's toys, like, authentically. You had to cut costs. Your face is horrible. That's not why I just smashed you in it. Like, I did that because you were a threat, but also your face is horrible. Oh.
Until you arrive, Father, I'm trapped here. Smuggling these gifts out is the most I can do to help.
Well, thanks, Eleanor. I appreciate it. I mean, all of that does sort of help me reaffirm what I'm doing here. Like, if you weren't constantly telling me that this is the right thing to do, then I would come to believe that perhaps I was, in fact, just some insane bastard. Up close and personal. Ooh, my drill does even more damage. Sick. I do appreciate that.
In ethical psychiatry, we must account for...
Eleanor Lamb speaking. Mum says I'm not to play with the other children because they're being raised on a diet of dog-eat-dog.
You have a very interesting way of speaking.
Dog-eaters. So I waited until Mum was gone and went out to find one. And guess what?
They don't eat dog.
Dog eaters wear human skins. It makes them look just like us.
Ugh. That's fucking weird. Little sister ahead. Okay then. So I need to kill the big daddy. Figured I might. You, wake up. First aid and an Eve hypo. Sick. Reactions on that are a bit interesting, huh? Vending machine. Wait, ow, fucked that up, didn't I? 50 caliber rounds. I still don't have, like, a gun that can use those, but thanks anyway, I guess. For the machine gun. Fair enough. And there he is.
Now that big daddy won't bite until you do. But to get to Lil Sis, you gotta put the old boy down for good.
I hear ya. Fuck you. Oh, whoops, I was on the trap rivets. Heavy rivets don't seem to do much more than regular. Fuck you, though. My drill's tougher than yours. Ow, Jesus. Maybe it ain't. I ain't going to time out, Pumpkin. Nothing personal, obviously. Ow. That fucking shit. I like how they still say unzip. Hey, look at that. Can I just walk you into my drill? Bam. Fuck you.
Take a breath, son. You did it. Now, just let her ride on your shoulders and she'll trust you like her own daddy.
Okay. Hello. What is this?
Daddy, are you taking me home too?
Apparently I am. Hello. Congratulations, you are now like a shoulder turret.
We're in business.
Why can't
now,
I give her a pistol or something?
There are corpses all over Rapture, and little dimples there can sniff out the atom on them. Find one.
Gotcha. Okay. I like how they had him in the microphone. Adam from Two Bodies. Fine. Let's see. Is there anything else, like, useful around here? Doesn't look like it. But I do like that my drill is apparently sick now. Press and hold R to get your little sister to lead you to a corpse. Uh-huh. Hey, buddy. Out of my way. Does it have to be the one that you're pointing at?
Adam is near.
Yeah, it does. Okay, then. Adam is near. Who's Adam? Adam and Eve.
She's got a juicy one, but when she starts draining out the atom, the splicers will come running.
Oh,
be ready
wonderful.
Before you set her down on that body.
Okay, so here you go.
That is a child of the family, not a toy for you to exploit and discard. It is fitting that you expire here.
Me?
One more forgotten curio in Ryan's shrine to the self.
How am I exploiting them, but you're fine?
Here they come. Keep the splicers off her now till she's finished, or they'll never give up the hunt.
Oh, great.
Go away. I think you'll find that I can ignore you, actually. Why do they do so much damage? Go away. Bastards. Go away. Fucking hell, this is annoying as shit. Hello, you're cutting through the wall. Stop that. Seriously. Good job. Am I?
Now you know the stakes, son. But a plasmid costs a bit more atom yet. Keep it up.
Great. Ammo, heavy rivets, extra dense rivets for industrial uses, fire slower, have massive increase in stopping power. Okay, so they're more like stun bullets than damage bullets. Shatter and impact, additional damage to most splicers. I have quite a lot of money. Let's stack up on that. Like, when I actually find the machine gun, that might be quite helpful. More stuff, healing station. Bing. Bang, boom. You do need some reactions on that. Which I appreciate, like, it's still better than the old one. but boy, I can't wait till I've got some form of defensive augment.
Why, hello there. My name is Andrew Ryan. I built the City of Rapture for children just like you, because the world above had become unfit for us. But here, beneath the ocean, it is natural to wonder if the danger has passed, if those we left behind will ever come to their senses.
So, no, probably not.
Let us imagine, you and I, what might befall us on the surface.
I told you about this one.
Did you?
Let's dance with them, Daddy.
A machine gun. Wow, this is a fucking bigger one than the... than the one from fucking, like, fucking regular Bioshock. Here you go, here's a Tommy gun. This one, fucking, here's a 50 caliber bloody Gatling rifle. Fuck yeah. Bang. I need to try and remember that it's on 4. Go away. That's not so bad. I have to wonder if the gun noises are tied into the, if the gun sounds are tied into the, music somehow. Because they seem strangely quiet. I don't know, maybe it's just not very loud. Where's the next body that we need, Pumpkin?
This way.
That way, okay. Let's see what else is around first, shall we? In case there's goodies. Maybe we can find you a teddy bear or some shit. You, me, in 1959?
I think all of the children have finally fallen asleep. And now that the park is all quiet, I can't sleep myself. I guess it's just you and me, Mr. Voice Recorder. You, me, in 1959. I wonder what the new year will... What? What was that? Something's happened. The lights are going out.
Uh-oh.
Stay in your sleeping bags. It's gonna be fine.
Uh-oh. So I wonder what happened there, then. 1959. That's when shit went down, wasn't it? Oh, those are round tracks. Isn't it? 1959? That was when, like, the Happy New Year party went south and Fontaine's splicers went off against Ryan's. Although I don't think he was Fontaine at the time, was he? He was Atlas. Excuse me. Anti-personnel rounds. That makes me feel like there's some anti-personnel problems
on the surface,
coming.
The farmer tills the soil, training the strength of his arm for a home and lands of his own. But the parasites say no. What was yours is ours. We are a state. We are God. We demand our share.
Well, that's messed up. Yeah, I'm already aware of that, right? Fucking go away. This way? Yeah, that's the way for the tour. I'm not interested. Ride maintenance, supplies only. Can I open this? Oh, I can, actually. Sick. Anything interesting? Bag that away for the guy. Yeah. Yeah, this might be later progress. Maybe then there's a... just a little side room for the Adam bullshit. Possibly. Looks that way. Ah, sick. I'll have this. Ow. Assuming I'm not dumb. Hey. Blue bonus for damage. Trap rivets. Let's see, what else we got? The corpse is... oh, this one. We did. Escape plan, what's this say?
I've been rationing my supplies ever since the park got cut off from the rest of Rapture. Gotta stay strong. I'm holed up in this workshop, surrounded by those wailing brats, trying to beat their way in. They want my food, my guns. They want it all. But I got a plan. I'm gonna fix up the transport sub that's been rusted in the maintenance bay.
Oh.
Then I'm gonna get the hell out of this hole. These animals want Rapture, they can have it.
I see. Ow. fuck's sake. Fucking things, I swear. I need some Eve, actually, now that I think about it. Much less, like, health and Eve stuff around. Much easier ammo. Oh, there's no vending machines here. Well, that's less than helpful. Bang. Bang. And some over here. You dig traps, right? Ta-da. Right then.
Adam, yep. Right,
yeah, I know, sweetie. There you go.
I do not hate you, Delta.
I hate you.
Indeed.
I've known you for like an hour, but
equal
fuck off.
To any other sentient creature. But I cannot sacrifice 1,000 of my children for one rebellious son.
Well, that's all right. I'm gonna kill them all anyway. Go away. Bastards. Fuck you. I've got a fucking huge drill. You and your dumb lab coat can't do anything about that. Fucking hell. Again with that damage, I swear. Jerks. Fuck off. Like, this seems like a lot of splices and a lot of damage. I mean, I guess I am still doing okay, though, and so it's not like I've died. But it just seems so... so harsh. Bastards. You find the atom? Ugh. That's gross. Apparently we are.
All right, Chief. We've almost got enough Adam now. To get the rest, you'll have to take care of that little sister. There should be one of the air vents they favor in the workshop.
Gotcha.
Bring her down there.
Okay. Fuck's sake. I need to get used to the guns. I need to get used to being, like, weak to bullets. I need to get used to aiming this thing. Hello. Do you do something, or are you just sparking for reasons? Oh. Figures.
Lam is becoming.
Is she?
Was a damned collectivist. Here in Rapture. How could the council fail to see it?
What the hell is a collectivist?
To hide her intent, she gulls these patients of hers into religious frenzy.
Oh.
Rise and swallow the council house before they realize they've been had. My son is swallowed by the parasite. Whatever its guise. It is time, I think, to call Sinclair.
Sinclair? As in the toy maker. Why? Okay, Sinclair, I'm suddenly suspicious of you and your role in Rapture. Anything cool up here? I know this isn't the way to go, but this seems like somewhere there might be some neat shit.
I saw the heavens open. I saw
yes.
Open.
Sick.
Rapture is a paradise of the ego, Eleanor. Under Ryan, the voices of an entire city sing the virtues of greed and pride. But truth, rather, is in the body. Already they grow weary of struggling against one another in fruitless competition. Observe the bent backs, the drawn faces. Ryan promised us more, they seem to say. In what shall we now believe? And Eleanor, it is our task to
On the surface,
fair enough.
The scientist invests the power of his mind in a single miraculous idea and naturally begins to rise above his fellows. But the parasites say no. Discovery must be regulated. It must be controlled. And finally, surrendered.
So yeah, basically everybody in Rapture is just a collection of people with shitty philosophies. Lovely stuff.
challenge his audience and make his vision immortal. But the parasites say, no, your arms serve the cause. Your ideals endanger the people.
There's something to be said for the difference between true freedom and the indication of freedom. More shit. Read this.
Where is my doll?
I don't know. Maybe the same place as your dentist. Hell. Anything cool down here? Look out for the water. Ow. Okay, so that does hurt me, good to know. By which I of course mean that's bullshit. Can I not do anything with this until it's hacked? Fine. Fine, I guess. Why was this helpful? Whatever, I guess. Anything else? Toolbox, what do you have for me? Nothing.
Lacking its own ingenuity, the parasite fears the visionary. But it cannot plagiarize, it seeks to censor. But it cannot regulate, it seeks to ban. Rapture was founded on an idea, and here they are held inviolate.
Fair enough. There are, you know, there are merits to the idea, but in practice, I think building it under the ocean was probably a mistake. Like, seriously, it's not easy to leave Rapture or get into it, which, you know, I guess is also kind of the point, but, like, come on.
Now, Tannenbaum would have you turn that sister human again. You'll get just enough atom for our purposes, and the girls will likely try to repay you somehow. But Rapture's a high-stakes town, son, and she is a jackpot. You just have to be willing to take it all. You'll harvest more atom than the price of one plasmid, so the rest is gravy. Think about it. Down here, it's your survival or hers.
Yeah, well, here's a fun fact. Given the choice between saving myself and saving any random child in the street, I would save the child. On account of I'm not the kind of person who lets children die.
Picking through the trash for scraps to eat.
I'm also not the- ow. I'm also not the kind of person who fucking murders children. You fucking weirdo. Seriously, like, I get, like, it's supposed to be a moral dilemma. More power now in exchange for some, like, murdering a child. But, again, murdering a child is fucked up. No matter which way you splice it. Need me some hypos. Thank you. It's fine. Anything else? Vita chambers. Why not? Choose whether to rescue a harvester. Maximum Adam. She won't survive. Rescue her. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I get it already. Yeah. On account of I'm not a murderer.
Tin Man had a heart all along. Personally, I call that a liability. But
yeah.
You have enough atom now. Barely. Head to the Hall of the Future and splice up with Incinerate.
Sure thing, Sinclair. I do not trust that guy at all. Tannenbaum does, for whatever reason, but he very clearly is morally ambiguous and definitely did some work for Ryan at some point. Yeah, that was scary and whatever. Get fucking shredded. Ow. What the fuck happened to you? Oh god. Ow. Fuck off. Man, the aim on this thing is not good. Ta-da. And this is supposed to be the one that does extra damage to people. Jeez. I mean, I guess maybe if I had upgraded the damage that would help, but whatever. Fuck off. Take your weird fish face and just leave me alone. Fucking religious zealot bullshit.
On the surface, your parents sought a private life, using their great talents to provide for you. They learned to twist the lies of church and government, believing themselves masters of the system. But the parasite said, no, the child has a duty. He will go to war and die for the nation.
Yeah, that's pretty fucked up. I mean, like, again, hilariously propagandic, but, you know, there is something to be said about conscription. I'm not going to say anything about it, because we don't get that here in England. Still, I think we're done for this episode, so thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next episode.